Let's practice finding the slope of the tangent line at a point with this problem. So we want to find the slope of the tangent line to f of x equals 1 over x plus 4 at the point x equals 2. And to do that, we want to use the definition that's shown here below. So the slope of the tangent line is given by the limit as h goes to 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a over h. And that's the slope of the tangent line at the point x equals a. Okay, so let's apply this definition to our function and point. So the slope of the tangent line equals the limit as h goes to 0 of f, in this case the point we're interested in is 2, so this is going to be f of 2 plus h minus f of 2 all over h. Okay, so let's go ahead and plug in our function. So to evaluate f of 2 plus h, I'm going to simply plug in 2 plus h for x in f of x. So in other words, that's going to look like 1 over 2 plus h plus 4. Okay, and then minus f of 2, so that's 1 over 2 plus 4. And that's all over h. Okay, so if I simplify a little, this is the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 over 6 plus h minus 1 over 6 in the top, and that's all over h. Now, you should remember from a few sections ago, maybe a limit that has this form where we have fractions in the top. And note that if we plug in 0 here at this point, we would get 1/6 minus 1/6, so 0 over 0. So this is a situation where we have to do more algebra. And like I was starting to say, if you watched the previous videos, maybe you remember that this type of form, it's often helpful to find a common denominator with those fractions on top, and then that'll allow us to simplify and cancel some things out. So what's the common denominator going to be in this case? Okay, well, the common denominator is often just the product of the two denominators. So in this case, the common denominator is going to be 6 times 6 plus h. So basically, I want to rewrite those fractions in the numerator so that they both have that denominator. So to do that, the first fraction, 1 over 6 plus h, needs the factor of 6. So I'm going to rewrite it as 6 over 6 times 6 plus h. So notice that if I canceled out that 6, I'd return to my original form. My second fraction needs the factor of 6 plus h. So that's going to become 6 plus h over 6 times 6 plus h. Okay, and then of course that's all over the h in the denominator. Alright, so now that I have that common denominator up top, I can subtract those fractions now. So if I do that, it's going to look like this. 6 minus, so I've got 6 minus the quantity 6 plus h. I just need to remember to distribute that subtraction sign to both terms. So it'll be 6 minus 6 minus h over 6 times 6 plus h. That's all in the numerator, and that's all over h in the denominator. Okay, so we're making some progress here because I see that in the numerator of my numerator, I've got 6 minus 6. So that's going to get me minus h. So minus h over 6 times 6 plus h, all over h. Okay, so now I'm at the point where I want to get rid of all this fraction within a fraction mess. So to do that, I need to remember the rule that dividing fractions, or dividing by a fraction, is equivalent to multiplying by its reciprocal. So a way that I can rewrite this is negative h over 6 times 6 plus h times the reciprocal of the denominator. So in this case, that would be times 1 over h. So now I see, after I've written it in this form, it makes it easier to see that I have a factor of h that I can cancel out, since I'm just looking at the limit at 0. Okay, so I'm left with limit as h goes to 0 of negative 1 over 6 times 6 plus h. Okay, so now I am at a form that is continuous at 0, which wasn't the case before. So now to finish out evaluating this limit, I just need to plug in 0. So that's going to get me negative 1 over 6 times 6, or negative 1 over 36. And that's my final answer. Negative 1 over 36 is the slope of the tangent line to this function at x equals 2.